Hello, everybody. It is Graham, your book daddy. Yes, we're still going with book daddy. Why? Because I like books and I'm a dad. That's going to be my personality, book daddy. Yeah, call me daddy in the comments. With that being said, it is my first book haul of the channel. I went shopping a lot this week. A lot of stuff happened, like my son Finn went and got his second flu shot. Sad day. Tears down his face. But when he gets that, he falls asleep in the car, and so I don't really want to take him home with all the busy dogs to wake him up from his awesome nap, so I decided to go book shopping a little bit. Also, a new bookshop opened here in Arizona, and I wanted to go check it out. I didn't go first day because it's always crazy that, but I wanted to go see and support and be like, yes, bring us more books and check it out as well. So that happened this week too. So what did I end up getting? Where did I go? Well, I first went to that bookshop I was talking about. I'll have a picture pop up here. It's called Book Off. It started in Japan, or it's a Japanese store. There's a lot in California. They just expanded here to Arizona, and it's cool. They do video games, a lot of video games, a lot of anime stuff, which I'm a fan of, a lot of manga. And their books, even though it's called Book Off, wasn't as big or had things I was looking for, I guess you could say, at the location. So yeah, I ended up picking up one book there, and the only reason I picked it up was because it was a familiar author's name. So it's a John Vandermeer, and it's Born, right? I really love John Vandermeer's cover. If you don't know, he is the author who wrote Annihilation, and a lot of people have been enjoying that. And so I saw this, and I was like, hey, you know what? I want to support this bookshop. I'm familiar, or I've been wanting to read one of John Vandermeer's books. I know they're a little bit challenging, and the cover just looks really, really cool. So yeah, did I say John this whole time? Jeff Vandermeer. Ugh, I'm the worst. But Jeff Vandermeer, pretty much this book is the beginning of a series he has, and it's about a young woman named Rachel who survives as a scavenger in a ruined city half destroyed by drought and conflict. The city is dangerous, littered with discarded experiments from the company. A biotech firm now derelict and punished by the unpredictable predations of a giant bear. One day, Rachel finds Born during a scavenging mission and takes him home. Born as a salvage is a little more than a green lump, plant, or an animal, but exudes a strange charisma. Against her instincts, Rachel keeps Born. She cannot help herself. Born makes Rachel see beauty in the desolation around her. She begins to feel a protectiveness she calls ill afford. She can ill afford. But as Born grows, he begins to threaten the balance of power in the city, laying bare to Rachel how precarious her existence has been and how dependent on subterfuge and secrets. In the aftermath, nothing may ever be the same. So yeah, I guess this cool looking flower heart stork creature, whatever, is Born. So that's even cooler than I thought. So this looked great. I picked it up, really excited to read Jeff Vandermeer's works. And yeah, that's what started the week off, was checking out Book Off, which now is open in Mesa, Arizona. So if you live in Arizona, go check it out. It was pretty fun. They take books too, so you can trade books in there too. The next place I went to was the thrift store shopping. So Goodwills, I think, are across the country. We are, at least in our state, I almost call Arizona country. Wow. In our state, we have Goodwills and we also have Savers, but Finn got his shot, we were driving by, I saw a Goodwill, I was like, I'll stop in and see what the heck is in there. Sometimes they have good books, sometimes they don't. And this time I found two books, which are really cool. So the first one is a really beat up copy, but it was only $2, of Hyperion. Yeah, Hyperion, a fantasy novel. It's been really popular here on YouTube lately by Dan Simmons, Hyperion. And so I was like, you know what? I'm gonna pick it up and I'm going to give it a read and see what all the hype is about. So I'm excited to jump into this at some time. It's not gonna be this month. None of these books I think are gonna be this month, really. I just wanted to add them to the collection because there's something I wanted to read. And you can't go wrong with used books. Yes. But Hyperion by Dan Simmons. I know nothing really about it. I've seen people rave about it, but I didn't really stay long enough to like know, or I don't think I watched the videos. I just saw people being like, this is awesome, I read this, and that was it. It was like a recap of what they read for the month. But pretty much what this book is on the world called Hyperion, beyond the law of hegemony of man, there awaits the creature called the Shrike. There are those who worship it, there are those who fear it, and there are those who have vowed to destroy it. In the valley of time tombs, of the time tombs, where huge brooding structures move backwards through time, the strike waits for them all. On the eve of Armageddon, with the entire galaxy at war, seven pilgrims set forth on a final voyage to Hyperion, seeking the answers to the unsolved riddles of their lives. Each carries a desperate hope and a terrible secret. And one may hold the fate of humanity in his hands. A stunning tour de force filled with transient awe and wonder, Hyperion is a masterwork of science fiction that resonates with an excitement and invention. The first volume in a remarkable new science fiction epic by the multiple award-winning author of The Hollow Man. So yeah, can't wait to jump in for Dan Simmons. This will be my first time reading one of his books as well. And I'm just stoked I found a copy at Goodwill. So cool. You can see the sticker. This is my big pet peeve with freaking Goodwill, is they put stickers on it and it rips the cover and you're like, ah. So, whatever. The second book, not fantasy related, it's my only fantasy or science fiction pick of that's not that I found, but this is a collection of essays called When You Are Engulfed in Flames by David Sedaris. This is a new thing for me. People probably already know a lot about this book, I don't know. But I was literally watching some videos and somebody talked about how this was one of their favorite books of all time. And it's a collection of essays about death, which I like thinking about that for some reason, not in a depressing way. Guys, you don't need to call any hotlines on me. It's just a concept I like to dwell upon and think about. And so, yeah, I'm excited to read this collection of essays that's about that. My wife and I got married a few years ago. I got a lot of her books in our collection. And, you know, I wasn't really, like, gung-ho in reading that much. I wasn't reading that much back then, so I didn't really sit there and dissect her collection. So I went to go put David Sedaris in there. We actually had another one of his novels, Naked, on there. And I was like, oh, cool. So if I really enjoy this collection of short stories, I'll be able to jump in and read Naked, which is cool, because I already have it, apparently. So that's awesome. Excited to get into David Sedaris, and we are engulfed in flames. Before we move on, let's go ahead and tune in to the Graham that is out in the wild right before he went and bought the next books at Half Price Books. What's up, guys? It is Graham out here, out in the wild. So I'm over here at Half Price Books here in Mesa, Arizona. And let's go check it out. I hope those camera angles were fantastic. I hope it was great. I call that the hashtag baby cam because I had it on the stroller and I was just like pushing it through Half Price Books while trying to like record. I probably should have asked permission. Let's be honest, guys. Ask permission if you're about to go record in a store. There's people around, but I don't know, I clam up. Sometimes when I'm around people, I just go like, I don't really want to talk. And I'm like pretty extroverted, but there's just sometimes I don't want to be a bother, especially in businesses. And so, yeah, so we were doing some baby cam footage there. And so, yeah, so let's first jump into the book that you saw probably at the end there. This book I know nothing about. There's no inkling in mind. The cover really spoke to me. It was also positioned in the prime spot to get people's attention. And it was $4. So I couldn't go wrong with it. And that is Spider Touch. This really cool cover with this hand making like that type of thing going on, and there's a cityscape and like the cool sun. I just really like the colors and how this pop. I think it's a really pretty cover, and it's by Angry Robot, which is a publishing company that I know only for another book called The Coward. I haven't read that book yet, but I think it's a cool looking cover. That cover was really nice looking as well, and the feel is pretty cool. So I'm excited to get into it. And the reason I picked it up wasn't just because the cover was cool. I do judge books by its cover sometimes. But also, it was the back. In Enslaved City, under siege, who is the real enemy? when he was a boy, Razvan trained as a translator for the hated Kida, the mute enslavers of his city, Valkedic. They keep a tight hold on the citizens by forcing their children to work in dangerous mines until they turn 18. By learning fingerspeak, the Kida's touch language, Razvan was able to avoid such a punishment and has etched out a quiet life for himself as an interpreter for the Kida court. He does not enjoy his work, but keeps his head down as the Kida reward any parental misdemeanors with extra lashings for their children. But now the city is under siege by a new army who might be even more cruel than the Kida. At the same time, a mysterious rebellion reaches out to Razvan to utilize an incoming attack to defeat the Kida once and for all. Razvan must decide which side to fight on, who could be trusted, and what truly deserves to be saved. There's not a lot about this book. I have no idea. I didn't look up reviews, anything. But maybe I should. Maybe it's problematic. I don't know. But I think the thing that really captured my attention is the fingerspeak, right? It seems like there's an interesting language involved there that doesn't involve words. And that kind of fascinates me in a world-building perspective and how that's going to be handled in a book. Obviously, they could be like, this means this, and I can read that. But I'm curious if it's going to be described, how well it's going to go. And it's by Alex Thompson. Yeah, so I hope it's cool. It's filed under Linguistical Nightmare. Nice. That's interesting. So anyways, that is Spider Touch. Pick it up. Last but not least was just something to be added to my collection. It's when I get to eventually. And as I was walking through, I walked past the romance section to get to the sci-fi section. For some reason, in the romance section was like a pristine copy of Red Seas Under Red Skies by Scott Lynch, which is the second book to the Lies of Lacamoire series. And I have never read this series. I have the first book here on my shelf somewhere. Ooh, it's right behind me. Yeah, I have the first paperback on my shelf. Whoop. And I was like, well, when I read that, then I can now have the second book. I think it's the second book, yeah. And so, bam, bam. So now I have both, which is really exciting. So that's cool. So the Gentleman Bastard series, I have the second book for. A lot of YouTubers that love this series, and or booktubers, sorry. But yeah, I'm excited. This sounds really cool, and I'm excited to eventually get reading on to this series. This is one of those series where I know it's going to be awesome. Like, I have a feeling I'm really going to vibe well with it. And if I don't, I'll be bummed. But so I'm just haven't been in a rush to read it because, like, I have other books that are just exciting for me. But I know I'll probably vibe really well with this. And so this is one of those, like, all right, I'm ready. I'm in the mood. Kind of like how Jade City was, where it's like, I have all the books. Let's just go. So you'll see this eventually get read. So that's kind of my book haul. I got 5 books. It's a small haul, but a lot for me. I'm not supposed to be buying books right now, so shame on me. But I decided to share that with you guys. And yeah, have any of you read any of these books? If so, what did you think about them? Are any of them bad? Has anybody even heard of Spider Touch? Am I the only one that's going to read this on BookTube? If so, cool. But yeah, guys, thanks for watching as always. It's a pleasure for you to be here. And as always, I'll see you next time. Toodles.